Hi everybody, thank you for watching my video on physics. Today, our discussion is on temperature time graph. In this video, we shall learn how to draw a temperature time graph and compare the heat capacities of two objects by comparing their temperature time graphs. When heat Q is supplied to an object X, its temperature T varies. This data can be shown in the temperature heat graph, TQ graph, as shown in the diagram. Assume that the power P of the heater is a constant. The heat supply Q is directly proportional to the time taken T. This is because Q equal to P times T. Therefore, the temperature time graph TT graph is similar to the TQ graph. Please note that in plotting a graph, the quantity that can be controlled by us is represented in the horizontal axis. That is, the horizontal axis represents the independent variable which causes changes in the vertical axis. Now, let's repeat the experiment with another object Y using the same power. We may get another TT graph. How do you compare the heat capacity of X to that of Y? Now, we can view the problem in two ways. Firstly, let's draw a vertical line cutting the time axis at time T1. For the same time interval, the same amount of heat is supplied to X and Y. Since Y has a greater temperature change, it has a smaller heat capacity, that is Cy less than Cx. Alternatively, we can draw a horizontal line cutting the temperature axis at T1. For the same temperature change, Y takes a shorter time. Since Y requires less heat for the same temperature change, it has a smaller heat capacity. Again, Cy less than Cx. In summary, a temperature time graph tells us how fast the temperature change with the heat supplied. We can compare the heat capacities of two objects from their TT graphs. Before we end, I would like to ask you a question. Can you make a conclusion on how the heat capacity of an object is related to the slope of the temperature time graph? Be the first to write your answer in the comment below. You may also write your comment on the answer of other people. I hope this video can help you understand about the graphical representation of heat capacity. Thank you for watching.